القسم الثاني عبقرية عمر رضي الله عنه.
So the Sheikh said that the second category of the genius of Umar رضي الله عنه.
إنه كان يتتبع أحوال الرعية.
It is that he used to follow the affairs of his people.
وأحوال الشعب.
And he would look towards caring for the people.
فكان عبقريا في إحكام الدولة.
And he was a genius when it came to ruling his kingdom.
فكان يتتبع احتياجات الناس.
He would look for the needs of the people.
يقف مع الضعفاء.
And he would stand shoulder to shoulder with the weak.
ويعين الضعفاء.
And he would help the poor.
حتى يستتب الأمر والأمن في الدولة.
So that peace and security would be established in the خلافة.
أذكر لكم إخواني بعض القصص التي حصلت لعمر رضي الله عنه في ذلك.
So the Sheikh said that I want to give you some examples and some stories regarding this.
في يوم الأيام قدمت مجموعة من التجار إلى المدينة.
One day a group of businessmen came towards Medina.
فنزلوا عند أبواب المدينة.
And they came towards the entrance or the outskirts of Medina.
فقال عمر رضي الله عنه وهو الخليفة.
And Umar said, and he was the Khalifa at this time.
قال لعبد الرحمن بن عوف.
He said to عبد الرحمن بن عوف.
هل لك أن نحرسهم الليلة من اللصوص؟ أن نحرسهم الليلة من اللصوص؟
He said, is it possible tonight to guard these people from thieves?
قال نعم.
He said yes.
فأخذا يحرسانهم.
So the two of them, they spent their night protecting them, guarding them.
فأخذ عمر الخطاب وعبد الرحمن بن عوف يصليان خلال هذا الليل وهما يحرسان.
And whilst they're guarding, they spent their time praying during the night.
فسمع عمر رضي الله عنه في الليل بكاء صبي.
So during that night, he heard the crying of a child.
فتوجه إلى الخيمة التي توجه إلى المكان الذي فيه الصبي.
So he went to the tent where he heard this crying.
فقال لأمه اتقي الله وأحسني إلى صبيك.
And he said, addressing the mother, fear Allah and be good to your child.
ثم رجع إلى مكانه.
And then he went back.
بعد فترة سمع بكاء الصبي.
Then after a while he heard the crying again.
فدعا ذهب إلى أمه وخاطبها.
So he went back to the tent and spoke to the mother.
اتق الله واحسن إلى صبيك.
And he said, fear Allah and be good to your child.
ثم عاد إلى مكانه.
Then he returned.
في آخر الليل سمع الصبي يبكي.
And then towards the end of the night the child was crying again.
فذهب إليها.
So he went back to the tent.
قال ويحك أيتها المرأة.
And he said, woe to you.
إني لا أراك أم سوء.
Verily, I think that you're an evil mother.
ما لي أرى ابنك لا يقر الليلة لا ينام الليلة.
Why has your child the whole night not settled?
فقالت هذه المرأة وهي لا تعلم من هذا.
And she, the mother, responded, and she didn't know who she was speaking to.
قالت يا عبد الله.
She said, "O slave of Allah."
قد أضجرتني وآذيتني الليلة.
The whole night you've been bothering me.
إني أحاول معه أن يفطم أريد أن أفطمه.
I want to feed him.
أريد أن أفطمه الآن في مثل هذه الحالة.
I want to feed him this night.
ويأبى.
And he refuses.
قولي ما تفطميه.
So why?
قالت لأن عمر لا يفرض للرضيع إلا إذا كان فطيما إلا إذا كان يأكل أما الذي يشرب اللبن لا يفرض له معنى.
She said that I'm trying to feed him, give him food, because عمر رضي الله عنه doesn't sponsor the child who's too young to eat.
قال وكم له من العمر؟
So Umar asked, how old is he?
قالت كذا شهر شهرين عمر.
Said he's a few months old.
قال عمره شهران ثلاثة أشهر وتفطمين بالطعام.
So he said, Umar said he's 2-3 months old and you're already trying to give him solid food.
ويحكي لا تعجليه.
Don't do that, you're hastening him.
قالت عمر ما يعطي إلا الفطيم أريد أن أفطمه.
She said, but I don't get money, financial support until he starts eating.
فقال عمر سيفرض لي للفطيم ولغير الفطيم.
So then Umar said, don't worry, Umar will sponsor you and the children that eat and don't eat.
فقال عمر ويحك يقول لنفسه ويحك يا عمر.
And then he said, Umar said to himself, won't you, O Umar?
كم قتلت من أولاد المسلمين؟
How many children lost their lives because of you?
فصلى الفجر.
And then he prayed Fajr.
قال وما يستبين الناس قراءته من غلبة البكاء.
And the people said that we couldn't understand his recitation because of his crying.
فلما سلم من الصلاة.
And then when he finished his prayer.
قال يا بؤس يقول لنفسه يا بؤس لك يا عمر.
He said to himself, may you be destroyed, O Umar.
كم قتل عمر من أولاد المسلمين؟
How many children died because of you?
فأمر مناد ينادي في المدينة.
So then he told a caller to call out throughout Medina.
ألا تعجلوا صبيانكم لا تعجلوا صبيانكم قبل الفطام.
That don't hasten in having your children eat solid food.
فإن نفرض لكل مولود في الإسلام.
For verily we will help each and every child born in Islam.
فكتب هذا لكل الآفاق ولكل المدن التي في دولة الإسلام.
And then he spread this rule across all of his lands.
يقول الراوي خرج عمر رضي الله عنه في ليلة من الليالي.
One night Umar came out during the night.
في الليل في منتصف الليل.
In the middle of the night.
فرآه طلحة.
And Talha saw him.
طلحة بعيد الله من عشر مبشرين في الجنة.
Talha is one of the senior companions, one of the 10 promised paradise.
فرأى عمر دخل بيتا.
And he saw that Umar entered into a house.
ثم دخل بيت آخر.
And then he went to a second house.
فلما أصبح طلحة.
And then in the morning, Talha.
قال عمر يذهب إلى من؟
Talha thought to himself, I wonder who these houses belong to.
فذهب إلى ذاك البيت.
So he went to the first house.
فإذا امرأة عجوز.
He saw within it an old woman.
عمياء.
Blind.
مقعدة لا تستطيع الحركة.
And she is too old to move.
فقال لها طلحة.
So he said to her,
ما بال هذا الرجل يدخل عليك ويأتيك؟
What about this man who came to you last night? He entered upon you.
قالت إنه يتعاهدني من كذا وكذا يوم.
She said that he comes to me. He's been coming here from such and such a time.
يأتيني بما يصلحني ويصلح حالي.
And he comes and he helps me.
ويخرج عني الأذى وينظفني.
And he comes and he cleans me.
فقال طلح لنفسه.
So Talha said to himself,
ثكلتك أمك يا طلحة.
May your mother be bereaved of you, O Talha.
أعثرات عمر تتتبع تتبع عمر.
Are you trying to follow the secrets of Umar?
من تتبعي لأحوال الناس وإعانته.
And from the care that Umar and the attention that Umar prayed for paid towards his people.
يقول مولاه أسلم.
His freed slave Aslam said.
قال خرجنا مع عمر رضي الله عنه إلى أحد أطراف المدينة.
He said that one day we went with Umar رضي الله عنه towards the outskirts of Medina.
حتى إذا وصلنا إلى مكان.
Until we came to a place.
إذا نار تشعل.
We saw a fire being lit.
قال يا أسلم.
So he said to me, Oh Aslam.
إني أرى هؤلاء أو ها هنا ركبانا.
He said that I think that there are travelers here.
قصر بهم الليل والبرد أي اشتد عليهم الأمر.
And they spent the night here and it was cold and difficult for them.
انطلق بنا إليهم.
So let us go to them.
قال فخرجنا نهرول أنا وعمر رضي الله عنه.
So we hastened, we ran towards them.
حتى دعونا منهم.
Until we came close to them.
فإذا بامرأة معها صبيان.
And we heard a woman with children.
وقدر منصوب على نار.
And we saw a bowl or a pot upon fire.
والصبيان يبكون ويتصايحون في الليل.
And the children are crying that night.
فقال عمر السلام عليكم يا أهل الضوء.
So Umar said, السلام عليكم أو people of the fire.
فقالت المرأة وعليكم السلام.
And the woman responded وعليكم السلام.
فقال لها أدنو هل أقترب ممكن أن أقترب.
So Umar said can I come closer.
قالت أدنو بخير إذا تدنو بخير نعم ولا دع لا تأتي.
She said only if you're going to bring some good come close.
وهي لا تعلم من هذا. وهي لا تعلم.
She doesn't know who it was.
فدنا منها.
So he came close.
ثم قال ما بالكم.
And he asked them what's happening what's wrong.
قالت قصر بنا الليل والبرد.
She said that the night was difficult and cold.
قال ما لهؤلاء الصبي يبكون.
So he asked her, why are your children crying?
قالت الجوع.
She said because out of hunger.
قال وأي شيء في هذا القدر.
So he said to her, so what's in the pot?
قالت ماء.
She said it's water.
قال ماء.
He said only water.
قالت ماء حتى أسكتهم حتى يناموا كأن طعام حتى أسكتهم حتى يناموا.
She said that I want to give them the impression that something's cooking in the hope that perhaps they'll fall asleep before they realize there's nothing there.
والله بيننا وبين عمر.
And she said, and Allah will be the judge of me and عمر.
فقال عمر أي رحمك الله.
So عمر said, may Allah have mercy on you.
وما يدري عمر بكم.
Umar didn't know about you. He doesn't know what's going on.
قالت يتولى أمرنا ويغفل عنا.
So she said he follows the affairs. He looks after other people, but he forgets about us.
فالتفت عمر إلى أسلم مولاه.
So Umar looked at his freed slave Aslam.
قال انطلق بنا.
And he said let's go back.
قال فخرجنا نهرول.
So he said we ran.
حتى إذا أتى إلى مخزن الدقيق.
Until we came to the store where we used to keep flour.
فأخرج كمية من الدقيق.
And we took an amount of flour. And we took some fat. And then he carried it on his back.
أي كيس كبير من الدقيق مع الشحم قال
أحمله على ظهري. Meaning a whole sack of flour.
قلت يا أمير المؤمنين أنا مولاك أنا أحمله عنك.
So the slave said, I am your slave. Let me carry it for you.
قال أنت تحمل وزري يوم القيامة.
He said, Will you carry my sins on the day of judgment?
أحمله على ظهري.
But rather, help me to carry it on my back.
قال فحملته على ظهري.
So he said, I put it on the back of عمر.
فانطلق يهرول.
And then he ran towards those people.
حتى إذا وصل إلى المرأة.
Until he came to the woman.
فألقى الدقيق عندها.
And he gave her the flour.
وأخرج من الدقيق شيئا.
And he gave some of that flour. He took some out and gave it to her.
قال خذي من الدقيق وذري على في هذا الماء الذي في القدر.
Take some of this flour and mix it with this water.
ودعيني أنا أحرك الماء.
And let me come and mix it for you.
وجعلت تلقي وهو يحرك الماء.
So he began to mix the water with the flour.
ثم ينزل رأسه عند النار وينفخ على النار.
And then he would blow upon the fire.
يقول أسلم.
أسلم said.
حتى رأيت الدخان يدخل إلى لحية عمر ويخرج منها.
Until I could see the smoke entangling in the beard of عمر.
وهو ينفخ في الدخان.
And he's still blowing.
قال حتى طبخ لهم.
Until he cooked for them.
ثم أنزل القدر بعد ذلك.
And then he took off this pot.
فقال بغيري شئتني بشيء بإناء.
And he said, give me a bowl.
فأتته بإناء.
So she gave him a bowl.
فأفرغ فيه.
So he took something out.
قال أطعميهم.
And she said, and he said, give this to your children.
وأنا أبرد لكم هذا الطعام.
And I will make the rest of it cool for you.
فأخذت تطعمهم وتأخذ في الإناء وتطعمهم.
So she would take from the bowl, from the pot, and she would feed her children.
حتى شبعوا.
Until they were full.
وترك عندها الدقيق والشحم.
And he left the rest of the flour and the fat with her.
فقام فقمت معه.
So he and then he left.
فقالت المرأة.
So the woman said to him,
جزاك الله خير أيها الرجل.
May Allah reward you, whoever you are.
والله أنت أولى بالإمارة من عمر هذا الذي في.
You have more right to be the leader than عمر.
فقال لها قولي خيرا.
So he said to her, only speak good.
إذا اذهبي إلى أمير المؤمنين فإن وجدتيه ستجديني عنده.
And he said to her, in the morning, go and seek out the leader of the Muslims. If you find him, you will find me.
ثم تنحى عمر جانبا.
And then he left.
وجلس.
He went to the side and he sat.
فقلت له يا أمير المؤمنين.
So his slave said to him, "Oh, leader of the Muslims.
لماذا تجلس?
Why are you sitting here?
أطعمناهم وانتهينا.
We fed them. They're happy.
قال ما يرد علي. ما يرد علي.
But he didn't respond.
وخاطبه لا يلتفت إلي.
So he said, "I kept asking him and he didn't respond."
قال وأخذ ينظر إلى الصبية.
And then he began to look at those children.
وهم يتصارعون هؤلاء الطبيعة بعد.
And now that they're happy, they're playing and they're fighting.
إلى أن ناموا وهدأوا.
Until they calmed.
فقال الحمد لله.
And he said, All praise is due to Allah.
فقال يا أسلم.
And then he said, Oh Aslam.
إن الجوع أسهرهم وأبكاهم.
Indeed, hunger made them cry and kept them awake.
فأحببت ألا أنصرف حتى أرى ضحكتهم ولعبهم ونومهم وهدوءهم.
So I didn't want to leave until I saw them smile and play and sleep.
وفي يوم الأيام بينما كان يعس في الليل.
On another occasion, as Umar was walking during the night.
مر بمكان واسع في المدينة.
He passed by an open expanse of land.
فإذا ببيت الشعر.
And he saw within it a house of straw.
فدنا من بيت الشعر.
And he went to this old house.
فسمع أنين امرأة. سمع أنين امرأة.
And he heard the crying or the complaints of a woman.
وتأوه هذه المرأة.
And she's in pain.
ورأى رجلا قاعدا بقربه.
And he saw a man sitting close by.
فاقترب منهم فسلم.
So he went to the man and he gave salams.
فقال من أنت؟ عمر يسأل هذا الرجل من أنت؟
So Umar asked this man, who are you?
أي أنت رجل غريب.
Because I don't know you.
قال أنا رجل من أهل المدينة.
He said that I'm.
عفوا أنا رجل من أهل البادية.
He said I'm a Bedouin man.
جئت إلى أمير المؤمنين أصيب من فضله.
I came to Umar to ask his help.
قال ما هذا الصوت؟ اسمع أنين امرأة ما هذا الصوت؟
So Umar asked him why does your wife sound like she's in pain?
فقال الرجل لعمر رضي الله عنه.
So the man replied.
وهو لا يعلم من هو عمر.
And he doesn't know that this man is عمر.
قال انطلق انطلق أيها الرجل لحاجتك.
He said to him leave us be.
قال له عمر أخبرني ما هذا الصوت؟
عمر said no tell me what's wrong with her.
قال امرأة تلد.
He said that she's about to give birth.
قال هل عندها أحد يعينها؟
So he asked, doesn't she have anyone to help her?
قال لا.
He said no.
فانطلق عمر رضي الله عنه إلى منزله.
So Umar rushed back home.
فقال لامرأته كلثوم بنت علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه.
He said to his wife كلثوم.
قال هل لك في أجر ساقه الله إليك؟
And he said to her, are you looking for some reward that Allah has brought to you?
قالت وما هو؟
So she asked, "What's wrong?"
قال امرأة غريبة تلد ليس عندها أحد.
He said, "There's a strange woman, a foreigner, who's about to give birth. She has no one to help her."
قالت نعم ومرحبا إن شئت.
And so she said, "Yes, I'll go and help her."
قال فخذي معك ما يصلح لولادة المرأة.
So he said to her, "Take some water and whatever you need to help her with her birth."
من الخرق والطعام وغير ذلك.
Take food and take clothing and so on.
وأتيني بقدر.
And bring me a pot.
وشحم.
And some fat.
وحبوب.
And some grains.
فحملها عمر على ظهره.
And Umar carried all of this on his back.
فانطلق معه.
And then they left together.
وحمل هذا القدر العظيم.
And Umar was carrying the pot.
حتى وصل إلى البيت.
Until they came to this house.
فقال لها يا أم كلثوم ادخلي على المرأة.
And he said to his wife, "Go and tend to the woman."
فذهب عمر وجلس بقرب الرجل.
And Umar went to the man and sat with him.
فقال عمر للرجل أوقد لي نارا.
And he said to the man, "Light a fire."
فجعل عمر البرمة أو القدر على هذه النار.
And then he placed the pot on the fire.
وجعل فيها الماء وجعل فيها الدقيق والشحم.
And he mixed it with water. And he placed in the pot water, mixed it with flour and so on.
إلى أن تجهز الطعام.
Until he cooked for them.
في هذه اللحظة ولدت المرأة.
And by that time, the woman had given birth.
فقالت أم كلثوم تخاطب عمر رضي الله عنه.
So أم كلثوم said, speaking to عمر, his wife said to عمر,
يا أمير المؤمنين بشر صاحبك بغلام.
Oh, leader of the Muslims, give glad tidings to the father that he has a son.
سمع العربي تقول يا أمير المؤمنين.
So she heard, or the man heard, the wife of Umar addressing him as the leader of the Muslims.
فاضطرب هذا العربي.
So the Bedouin man became afraid. He became amazed.
ثم تنحى أخذ يتنحى خائفا.
And he began to move back from him. He's afraid.
قال عمر مكانك كما أنت.
So Umar said to him, "No, it's okay. Sit."
فحمل عمر القدر الذي فيه الطعام حتى جعله عند الباب.
And then he took the food and he placed it at the entrance of that house.
قال يا أم كلثوم.
And he said to his wife, أم كلثوم.
أطعميها حتى تشبعيها.
Give her this food until she's happy.
ففعلت.
And she did.
إلى ثم بعد ذلك أخرجت أم كلثوم القدر مرة أخرى إلى الخارج.
Until she gave the pot back.
فوضع عمر القدر بين يدي الرجل.
And then Umar gave the pot to the man.
قال كل فإنك قد سهرت الليلة.
And he said to him, "Eat because you've been awake all night."
ثم قال للرجل إن كان من الغد فأتينا بما حتى نعطيك ما يصلح أمرك.
And then he said to him, "In the morning, come and seek me out, and I will help you with what you need."
في يوم من الأيام بينما كان يعس في المدينة.
One night on another occasion, as Umar was walking in Medina.
انظروا إخواني كيف يتبع أحوال الناس.
Look at how Umar رضي الله عنه is paying attention to his people.
ويساعد الضعفاء ويساعد المحتاجين.
And he's helping the needy and the poor.
ما كان ينام في الليل.
Umar wouldn't really sleep at night.
كان حريصا على راحة الرعية.
But he was looking after his people.
بينما كان يسير في الليل.
So one night.
فمر على بيت.
He passed by a house.
فإذا امرأة تخاطب ابنته.
And he found that a woman was addressing her daughter.
قالت يا فلانة.
And she said to her daughter, "Oh my daughter."
قومي فاخلطي الماء باللبن.
She said, "Go and mix this milk that we have. Mix it with water, dilute it."
حتى نبيعه للناس على أنه لبن على أنه لبن صافي.
So that we can sell it in a greater quantity and people will think that it's milk.
قالت يا أمه.
So the daughter said, "Oh my mother."
إن أمير المؤمنين نهانا عن هذا.
Indeed, the leader of the Muslims, Umar, forbade us from doing so.
قالت دعيك من أمير المؤمنين.
She said, "Forget about Umar."
هو يسمعها.
And Umar is listening to them, but they don't know.
أين أمير المؤمنين الآن؟
How will Umar know what we do?
أمير المؤمنين نائم الآن.
He doesn't know.
قالت يا أمه.
She said, "Oh my mother."
إن لم يكن أمير المؤمنين يرانا.
Even if Umar cannot see us.
فإن رب أمير المؤمنين يرانا.
Indeed, the Lord of Umar sees us.
ارتجف عمر.
So Umar became amazed at his statement.
يقول أسلم مولاه رأيته يضطرب.
And Aslam, his slave, he said that I saw within him a physical change.
قال يا أسلم.
So he said, "Oh Aslam."
ضع علامة على هذا البيت.
He said, "Mark this house."
وأتني بخبر هذه البنية.
And in the morning, give me news of this girl.
دعك من أمها أريد خبر هذه البنية.
I don't want to know about the mother. I want to know about the daughter.
فصلى الفجر رضي الله عنه.
So after Fajr.
فجمع أبناءه.
Umar gathered his sons.
قال من منكم يريد أن يتزوج خير نساء المدينة؟
And he said to them, "Who from amongst you wants to marry one of the best women of Medina?"
فقال عبد الله بن عمر أنا عندي زوجة.
So Ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Umar said, "I'm married."
وقال ابنه الآخر عبيد الله أنا عندي زوجة.
And then his other son Ubaydullah said, "I'm married."
فقال عاصم أنا يا أمي يا أبتي.
So his other son عاصم said, "I want to marry."
قال اذهب فتزوج من فلانة.
So he said to him, "Go to that house and marry that girl."
فإنها من خير نساء المدينة.
For verily she is from the best women of Medina.
تزوجها.
So he married her.
أنجبت له ابنه.
And they had children, sons.
بنت أنجبت.
Sorry, he had a daughter.
وهذه البنت أنجبت عمر بن عبد العزيز.
And this daughter would be the mother of عمر بن عبد العزيز.
في يوم من الأيام يقول رجل بعثني أبي إلى المدينة.
One day a man said that my father sent me to Medina.
وكان معي مجموعة من العنز إلى المدينة.
And I had with me sheep and so on, a flock of sheep.
لأبيعها في المدينة.
So that I could sell it in Medina.
فلما اقتربت إلى المدينة.
So as I was drawing close to Medina.
فإذا أنا برجل عند أبواب المدينة.
I saw a man on the outskirts of Medina.
وقد مال حماري بعض الشيء مال حماري من كثرة.
And my donkey was lopsided because of the weight that it was carrying.
فقلت أخذت خاطب هذا الرجل.
So I said to this man that I saw.
يا عبد الله أعني على حمل حماري.
Oh slave of Allah, help me with this donkey. It has a lot of weight.
حتى أعدل الوزن.
So that I can balance the weight again.
قال نعم يا بني.
So he said okay.
فقام معي حتى عدلته.
So he helped me.
فقال لي من أنت؟
And then he said to me, who are you?
قلت أنا فلان بن فلان.
I said my name is so and so.
قلت فقال لي إذا أتيت أباك. فقال لي إذا أتيت أباك.
So he said to me, when you go back to your father.
فقل له إن أمير المؤمنين يقول لك.
Tell him that the leader of the Muslims says to you.
إياك وذبح الجدي. إياك وذبح هذه العنز.
He said, beware of or don't sacrifice this flock.
قلت من أنت رحمك الله.
So the boy asked, who are you?
قال أنا عمر أمير المؤمنين.
He said, I am عمر.
قلت عمر. وقلت له احمل معي حماري.
So the boy was like, this is Umar, and I asked him to help me with the donkey.
ما كان يجد أي حرج في هذا رضي الله عنه.
وعمر رضي الله عنه wasn't shy, he wasn't too arrogant and proud to help.
وفي ليلة من الليالي بينما هو يعس كذلك في المدينة.
On another occasion, as he was walking during the night patrolling Medina.
مر على امرأة تحمل قربة.
He came across a woman who was carrying.
فسأل عن شأنها. ما لك تحمل هذه القربة؟
Carrying a sack, so he asked her, what's wrong?
فقالت إن لي عيالا.
She said that I have family.
وليس لي خادم.
And I don't have anyone to help me.
وأخرج من الليل لأسقيهم.
So I go out during the night to look for water and so on.
ولا أحب الخروج بالنهار.
And I don't like to leave during the day.
قال دعي دعي القربة.
So he said to her, leave these vessels with me.
فحمل القربة رضي الله عنه.
And he carried the pot himself.
حتى وصل إلى منزله.
Until he came to the watering place.
قال في الصباح.
And in the morning.
اذهبي إلى عمر.
In the morning, you go to Umar.
ليعطيك خادما.
So that he can find for you a servant.
قالت من؟ أذهب إلى عمر.
So.
قالت أذهب إلى عمر.
She said, "Should I go to Umar?"
كيف أصل إلى عمر؟
He said, "Umar won't help us."
ومن أنا من النساء؟
And I am just a general woman.
قال إنك ستجدينه إن شاء الله.
She said, "No, you'll find." He said, "No, you'll find him in the morning."
فذهبت على وصيته.
So the next morning she went.
قالت أريد الدخول على عمر.
And she said that I want to see Umar.
قال له هذا عمر في المسجد.
So the people said this is Umar here.
فرأت.
So when she saw him.
فهو الذي حمل عنها القربة.
He is the same man that helped her last night.
فتركته وهربت أخذت تولي وتولول.
So she left him and she tried to run away.
فقال عمر أرسل إليها الخادم.
So Umar said send to this woman a servant.
وأعطوها نفقة.
And give her some wealth.
رضي الله تعالى عنه.
May Allah be pleased with him.
حتى كان يتتبع أحوال الأبناء مع والديهم.
He would also look after the affairs of the children and the way that they would treat their parents.
كان رجل يقال له أمية من سادات قومه.
There was a man by the name of Umayyah who was from the leaders of his tribe.
وله ابن يسمى كلاب.
And he had a child, a son by the name of Kilab.
وقد هاجر إلى المدينة في خلافة عمر.
And they had migrated to Medina during the reign of Umar.
ومكث فترة مع عمر رضي الله عنه.
And they spent some time in Medina.
فخرج هذا الشاب ابن هذا الرجل الكبير خرج في الغزوات.
So the son of the man, the son, he went and participated in one of the battles.
فقام أمية إلى عمر.
So Umayyah, the father, he came to Umar.
يا أمير المؤمنين.
And he said, O leader of the Muslims.
هذا اليوم من أيامي لولا كبر سني أنا أريد أن أشارك في مثل هذا لكن لولا كبر سني.
He said that I'm too old myself to participate in fighting.
فقال له الولد كلاب.
So the son said to him.
وكان عابدا زاهدا.
And he was a righteous man.
قال يا أمير المؤمنين.
He said, O leader of the believers.
أما أنا.
As for me.
فبيع الله نفسي.
He said that I want to sacrifice myself for Allah.
وبيع دنياي وأبيع دنياي بآخرة.
And I will sacrifice this life for the next.
تعلق به أبوه تعلق بابنه.
So the father he began to hold on to his son.
فقال يا كلاب لا تدع والديك.
So Umar said to him, O Kilab, look after your parents.
إنهما شيخان كبيران ضعيفان.
Because now they are elderly and weak in age.
ربياك صغيرا.
They looked after you, nurtured you whilst you were young.
حتى إذا احتاج إليك تركتهما.
And now that they need you, you will abandon them.
قال أتركهما لما هو أفضل من هذا.
He said, the son said, I will leave them for something better.
فذهب.
And he left.
فبينما عمر رضي الله عنه مر على هذا الأب.
And then Umar passed by the father one day.
فرآه يبكي.
And he saw him crying.
ورأته العجوز فبكت كذلك.
And his wife was crying.
فسأل عمر عن السبب.
So he asked them why.
فقال يا أمير المؤمنين ما أستطيع أن أتحمل فراق ابني.
They said because we are missing our son.
قال أتوني بابنه.
So he called for his son to come back.
وفعلا رجع إلى المدينة.
And then he returned to Medina.
فقال سأل عمر ابنه كلاب.
So the son he asked Umar.
عمر سأل
عمر asked the son
كيف ما بلغ من برك لأبيك ماذا كنت تفعل لأبيك.
He said what did you used to do to your father for your parents that they miss you so much.
قال كنت أثيره على نفسي وأكفيه كل أمره.
He said that I would sacrifice myself for them and do everything that they needed.
وكنت إذا أردت أن أحلب له لبنا.
And if I wanted to take some milk.
فأخذ ناقة وأريحها.
I would take the camel and I would let it rest.
وأترك حتى تستقر.
And I would wait for it to calm.
وأغسل ضروعها.
And then I would wash its udders.
حتى تبرد.
Until they became cool.
ثم أحلب فأسقي.
And then I would milk it and I would give it.
ليخرج أفضل أنواع اللبن.
So that the milk would be nice and sweet.
فبعث عمر إلى أمية إلى الأب.
So Umar he sent to the father.
وكان أبوه قد عمي.
And his father had grown old and became blind.
فجاء به ودخل عليه وهو محمول بين رجلين.
And he was so old that when he came before Umar, he had to be helped, assisted by two other people.
قال له عمر كيف أنت يا كلاب؟
So Umar said.
يا أبا كلاب عفوا.
So Umar said to the father, "How are you, O father of كلاب?"
قال كما ترى يا أمير المؤمنين.
He said, "You see how I am, O أمير المؤمنين."
قال ما أحب الأشياء إليك اليوم.
He said, "What would you prefer today? What would you love today?"
قال لا أحب شيئا.
He said, "There's nothing that I want."
لا يفرحني شيئا ولا يسيئني شيء.
He said, "Nothing benefits me, nothing harms me."
قال بل أخبرني.
He said, "No, there must be something you want."
قال يا أمير المؤمنين ابني كلاب.
He said, "O Amir al-Mu'minin, I would have my son."
أحب أن يكون عندي.
I love that he should be close to me.
أحب أن أشمه شمه.
And I would like to smell him.
وأضمه ضمه.
And that I should embrace him.
قبل أن أموت.
Before I pass away.
فبكى عمر.
So Umar cried.
فقال لابنه كلاب احلب لأبي كما كنت تحلب.
And he said to the son, go and milk for your father the way you used to.
فأتي بالإناء.
So
اللبن.
The vessel was brought before the father.
قال اشرب يا أبا كلاب.
And Umar said to him, drink.
وقدمه ابنه وقدمه له وهو لا يعرف أن ابنه.
And his son is there presenting his father with the milk, but he can't see him. Doesn't know it's him.
قال اشرب يا أبا كلاب.
So he said to him, drink.
فلما اقترب منه قال والله يا أمير المؤمنين إني لا أشم رائحة يدي ابن كلاب.
And as he was about to drink, he said, "O Amir al-Mu'minin, I can smell the hands of my son."
قال هذا كلاب ابنك بين يديك.
So Umar said, "This is your son in front of you."
فوثب على ابنه وضمه ضمه.
So he fell upon his son and embraced him.
فبكى عمر وبكى كل من حوله.
So Umar cried and those around him cried.
قال يا كلاب.
So Umar said, O Kilab,
إلزم أبويك.
Stay with your father.
فجاهد فيهما.
And make your jihad with him.
إياك أن تتركهما.
And beware of abandoning them.
أخواني من ذلك أن عمر رضي الله عنه في يوم من الأيام كان يعس كذلك في الليل.
On another occasion, as Umar was patrolling the city during the night,
فمر بامرأة.
He passed by a woman.
من نساء العرب وقد أغلقت باب بيتها.
From amongst the women who had locked the door of her house.
فتقول لقد تطاول هذا الليل وطال علي ليلي.
And she was saying that this night is long.
وليس لي خليل أتلاعب معه بالليل.
And I have no companion to comfort me.
قالت ويمر علي الليل ويذهب الليل ولا خليل عندي ألعب معه.
And she's saying that this night is long, but I have no one to comfort me this night.
والله لولا الله الذي أخافه.
He said, "By she said, by Allah, were it not that I feared Allah,
لدعوته رجلا رجلا يدخل علي ويحرك هذا السرير.
I would invite random men to come and spend the night with me.
ولكني أخشى الله.
But I fear Allah.
ثم تنفست تنفس صعداء تنفست بقوة.
And then she exhaled.
وقالت لو قالت لو عمر علم لهان على عمر وحشتي وغيبة زوجي عني. قالت غيبة زوجي عني.
She said, if Umar knew how I missed my husband,
لو علم عمر حالي لهان عليه ما أنا لربما أي تجاوب معي.
If Umar, sorry, if Umar knew my situation, he would help me.
ولكنه عمر لاهن عنه.
But Umar is far away.
وقف عمر.
So Umar stood.
فضرب الباب.
And he knocked on the door.
قالت من هذا الذي يأتي إلى امرأة في الليل ليس عندها أحد.
So she responded, who is this that comes to a woman during the night who's alone?
قال افتحي.
So he said, open the door.
قالت والله ما أفتح.
She said, no, I'm not going to open the door.
قال افتحي.
He said, open the door.
قالت والله لو علم بك أمير المؤمنين لعاقبك وضربك.
She said that if Umar knew that you were trying to enter my house, he would beat you.
فعرف عمر عفافها.
So Umar knew that she was a woman of modesty.
قال افتحي فأنا أمير المؤمنين.
He said to open the door, it is Umar.
قالت كذبت ما أنت بأمير المؤمنين.
She said, you're lying, you're not Umar.
فرفع صوته وجهر به.
So Umar raised his voice.
فقالت هذا صوت عمر.
So then she realized it is Umar.
ففتحت.
And she opened the door.
قال كيف قلتي؟
And he said to her, what did you say?
فعادت عليه قولها أنه لولا خشية من الله لجعلت الرجال يملؤون بيته.
And she repeated what she said that were it not for the fear of Allah, she would invite men into her house.
قال أين زوجك؟
So he said to her, aren't you married? Where's your husband?
قالت ذهب في بعد كذا وكذا وفي غزوة.
She said that he's on one of your battle expeditions. He's fighting somewhere.
فأرسل إلى الجيش وقال أرسلوا زوجها فلان بن فلان الآن يأتي المدينة.
And then he wrote to the leader of that, the general of that army, and he said, send so and so back now to Medina.
قال ذهب إلى أهلك إلى زوجك.
And then he said to him, go back home.
ثم ذهب إلى ابنته حفصة.
And then he went to his own daughter حفصة.
أم المؤمنين.
The wife of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قال أي بنية.
And he said, oh my daughter.
كم تصبر المرأة على زوجها.
How long can a woman be away from her husband?
قالت ربما شهر تصبر شهرا شهرين فأربعة نهاية الأمر أربعة.
She said perhaps a month or 2 months, but not more than 4.
وإلا نفض صبرها.
Otherwise she will become lonely.
سبحان الله كما قال الله عز وجل.
It is as Allah says.
للذين يؤلون من نسائهم تربص أربعة أشهر.
That the woman who is on her waiting period, she waits for 4 months.
فما يجوز للزوج أن يهجر زوجته أكثر من أربعة أشهر.
And the husband cannot abandon his wife for more than 4 months.
فجعل عمر هذا الوقت هو فقط لخروج الرجال من مدينتهم ثم رجوعهم إليها في الغزوات.
So Umar رضي الله عنه placed as a limit for the soldiers who traveled away a 4 month limit that within that 4 months they should return.
ومن خدمة عمر رضي الله عنه للناس والاحتياجات الناس.
And from the way that Umar helped others.
أنه لما قدم مبعوث سلم بن قيس بغنائم بعض فتوحات فارس.
When سلم ابن قيس came to take some of the booty of war.
فأخذ عمر يطعم الناس من هذه الغنائم ويوزعهم عليهم.
عمر رضي الله عنه was distributing the war booty.
وهو متكئ على عصا.
And he was leaning on a stick.
ويعاونه مولاه.
And his slave, his servants are helping him.
حتى يرى الناس من قد شبعوا وقد امتلأوا.
Until he saw that the people were taking what he was giving them.
وأني من ذلك أنه كان حتى يتدخل حتى في القضايا ليعرف ما هي أو كيف حل مثل هذه الألغاز.
The Umar رضي الله عنه used to look for the details of an issue so that he could help people solve their problems.
في يوم الأيام أتي عمر رضي الله عنه بفتى جميل وجد مقتولا.
Umar رضي الله عنه was presented one day by a young handsome boy who was murdered.
ومقتول ملقى في الطريق.
And he was murdered and left for dead on the road.
فسأل عمر حاول أن يتعرف على القاتل ما استطاع الوصول إلى القاتل.
So Umar was searching and investigating and looking for the murderer, but he couldn't find him.
فقال اللهم أظهرني بقاتله.
So he said, "Oh Allah, allow me to find the killer."
بعد سنة.
After 1 year.
وجد صبيا مولودا مقتولا وملقى في نفس المكان تقريبا.
He found a young child dead and thrown in the same location, left for dead.
تقريبا أقل من سنة رآه مقتول.
Younger than a year old.
فأتي به إلى عمر.
And he too was brought before Umar.
طبعا المولود ملقى لم يقتل هذا المولود ولكن ملقى في هذا المكان.
Oh, he wasn't dead, but he was left and abandoned in this place.
فقال عمر ظفرت بدم القتيل، عرفت من هو القاتل أنا.
But Umar said, I found out the murderer of that other boy.
بإذن الله تعالى.
By the permission of Allah.
فأخذ الصبي.
So he took this young child.
ودفعه إلى امرأة.
And he told a woman to look after him.
قال أرضعيه.
And he said to her, feed him.
وقومي بشأنه.
And look after him.
ونحن ننفق عليك.
And I will give you the money to look after him.
وانظري من الذي سيأتي ويلقي نظرة عليه أو يأخذه منك.
And look out for the man or for the person who comes to claim him.
فإذا وجدت امرأة تقبله وتضمه إلى صدرها فاعلميني بها.
And if you find that a woman comes and she kisses him and she embraces him and she claims him, then let me know.
شب الصبي وتربى عند هذه المرأة.
So the woman looked after this child and the child grew.
فجاءت جارية شابة.
And a young woman came by.
فقالت هذه الشابة قالت للمرأة.
So this young woman she said to the woman who's looking after the child.
إن سيدتي بعثتني إليك.
That my mistress sent me to you.
لتبعثي بالصبي لتراه ثم ترده عليك.
So that you can send this child to her. She wants to look after him and then she'll give him back.
نعم لا بأس.
She said okay.
بشرط.
But I have a condition.
أن أذهب أنا مع الصبي.
That I too shall accompany the child.
قالت نعم.
She said okay.
فذهبت بالصبي مع الجارية.
So they went together with this young girl.
حتى دخلت على سيدتها.
Until they went to the house of the mistress.
فلما رأته هذه المرأة.
So when the woman saw the child, the mistress,
إلى صدرها وأخذت تقبله.
She began to kiss the child and embrace it.
وهذه المرأة هي ابنة شيخ من الأنصار.
And this woman was the daughter of one of the people of the Ansar.
من الصحابة.
From the companions.
فأتت هذه المرأة التي ربت ذهبت إلى عمر فأخبرت.
So this woman that was caring for the child, that Umar asked to care for the child, she went to Umar.
فوضع سيفه عنده.
And Umar had his sword with him.
وتغطى.
And he covered himself.
ثم أقبل إلى منزل المرأة.
And he went to the house of this woman.
فوجد أباه متكئاً على الدار. أباه متكئاً على الدار.
And he saw that the father was old and he was leaning on a stick.
قال يا أبا فلان.
So he said, "Oh, father of so and so."
ما فعلت ابنتك فلانة؟
What did your daughter do?
قال جزاها الله خيراً يا أمير المؤمنين.
He said, "May Allah reward her with good."
هي من أعرف الناس بحق الله.
She always looks after my affairs.
ومن أعرف الناس بحق أبيها.
And she knows the rights of Allah and the rights of her father upon her.
مع حسن صلاتها.
And she's good in her prayer.
وصيامها.
And in her fasting.
وقيامها بدينها.
And in her general issues of religion.
فقال عمر رضي الله عنه.
عمر said to him.
أريد أو أحببت أن أدخل عليها فأزيدها رغبة في الخير وأحثها عليه.
He said that I want to enter upon her and increase her in good.
قال جزاك الله خيرا يا أمير المؤمنين.
So he said, may Allah reward you with good, O Umar.
امكث مكانك حتى أرجع إليك.
Wait here and I will bring her.
فاستأذن هذا الرجل عمر فدخل على ابنته.
So Umar then sought permission to enter. He was given permission.
ثم بعد ذلك خرج الرجل إلى عمر.
And the man returned to Umar.
فقال ادخل عليها.
He said, come in.
فدخل عليها.
So he entered upon her.
فقال عمر مر الناس يخرجون أي رجل هنا أو أي امرأة تخرج من هذا المكان.
So he said, ask everyone else to leave.
واخرج أنت كذلك.
And you, meaning the father, you leave as well.
واجعل الباب مفتوحا.
And leave the door open.
فبقي عمر مع المرأة.
So عمر stayed with the woman.
فما بقي أحد إلا هما.
And it was only عمر.
فكشف عمر عن السيف.
So عمر took out his sword.
قال اصدقيني.
And he said, "Tell me the truth."
وإلا ضربت عنقك بهذا السيف.
Otherwise, I will take off your neck.
وتعرف أن عمر لا يكذب. تعرف أن عمر لا يكذب.
And she knows that Umar is serious.
قالت على رسلك يا أمير المؤمنين.
He said, "She said, calm down, O Amir al-Mu'minin."
والله لا أصدق أنك.
I will speak the truth.
إن عجوزا كانت قد دخلت علي.
She said that an old person came upon me.
فاتخذتها بمثابة أمي.
And I treated this old woman like a mother.
وكانت تقوم من أمري بما تقوم به الوالدة.
And she would do for me what a mother does for her daughter.
وكنت لها بمنزلة البنت.
And I treated her like a mother.
فمكثت عندي دهر فترة.
And she stayed with me for a while.
ثم قالت لي يا بنية.
And then she said to me, oh my daughter.
إني أريد أن أسافر.
I want to travel.
ولي ابنة بنت.
And I have a daughter.
أخاف عليها أن تضيع.
I'm afraid that she will. No one will look after her.
فأحب أن أجعلها معك حتى أرجع من السفر.
So I want to keep her under your care until I return.
قال فعمدت إلى ابن لها أمرد أي لا لحية له ولا شعر.
So she gave me this child who was young in age.
وأنا لا أعرف أنه ذكر.
And I didn't know that the child was a boy.
هيئته كهيئة المرأة تماما.
But she appeared to me to be like a girl.
وأنا لا أشك بأنها جارية.
And I thought it was a girl.
فكان هذا الشاب يرى مني ما يرى الشابة من الشابة.
So because I thought she was a girl, I would do things that you would only do in the presence of other girls.
فكان يرى مني كل شيء.
And he would see everything that I did.
قال بينا في يوم الأيام أنا نائمة وهي تنام بقربي.
So one night as I was sleeping and he was sleeping close to me.
قال فما شعرت إلا وهو علي ويجامعني.
I found that he was having relations with me.
قالت فكانت بقربي سكين فأخذته وقتلته بها.
So I took a knife close by and I stabbed him.
فأمرت به فألقي.
And then I told him to be taken somewhere and left.
فحملت منه بهذا الصبي.
And from that I became pregnant.
فلما وضعته ألقيته في نفس مكان أبيه.
So when I gave birth to this child, I took the child and left it in the same place.
والله يا أمير المؤمنين هذا خبره.
So this is what took place.
افعل ما شئت.
And now you may judge upon me.
قال صدقت بارك الله فيك.
He said you have spoken the truth.
ثم أرضاها ووعظها ودعا لها وخرج.
And he made dua for her and he left.
فقال لأبيها بعدما خرج.
And then he said to her father.
نعمة هذه البنت بنتك.
He said that your daughter is a good woman.
ثم انصرف بعد ذلك.
And then he left.
هذا أخوان القسم الثاني عبقرية عمر رضي الله عنه.
So this is another category from the genius of عمر رضي الله عنه.
وهو أنه يتتبع أحوال الناس واحتياجات الناس.
And that is that he would look after the needs and the affairs of the people.
هذا قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما رأيت عبقريا يفري فرية.
As the Prophet told us صلى الله عليه وسلم that I haven't seen someone that has the genius of عمر.
حتى ضرب الناس بعطن أي امتلأت الأماكن بالمياه وارتاح الناس.
Until the people were happy and restful because of the water that he spread in the land.
وإذا كان عمر رضي الله عنه يبكي ويقول.
And that is why عمر used to cry and say.
أخشى أن تتعثر شاه في صحراء البلد هذا البلد الذي تحت إمرتي فيحاسب الله عز وجل هذا.
He said that I fear that even an animal that is harmed under my in my kingdom, Allah will hold me to account for it. And all praise is due to Allah. Okay, inshallah, we're going to stop there. Salat al-Asr is in about 15-20 minutes, 6 o'clock. And then inshallah, after the salah, we will begin with the next lecture. Jazakumullah khair.